Within a specific body. I'm using orange thread because it shows up pretty well on the camera. Cut off a length that's determined by cutting off too much many times. And it needs to be thoroughly waxed because the wax helps hold the body together after it's been spun. As a matter of fact, it's preferable to let the finished body sit overnight so that the wax hardens and then they don't come untwisted when you take them off the card to use. Run the thread through the slot at the bottom of the block, around the brad at the top, and down into the slot on the side. That holds half of the thread away from the surface while you're spreading out the dubbing, which is in the neighborhood here somewhere. I lost my dubbing, but I'm going to use some hairs here just to keep this going. Some people use tweezers to put this down. I tend to do it by hand with fussing around with it. And you'll notice that I'm putting less at one end of this than at the other. And the purpose is to end up with a body that's tapered in shape. So you have a minimum of fooling around to do when you put it on the hook and you want a tapered body. I get it generally distributed, as you see, and then I put the other strand of thread over the top and down through the notch on the bottom to hold it pretty much in place. And then I take a dubbing needle and then I just finish up with distributing the hair where I want it. Again, less at one end than at the other. When I get it in place, more or less like I want it, I take my hackle pliers . Trim the ends of the threads together so they're the same length. Grab them with an English hackles pliers and give it a spin. And that's building up a combination of tension on the thread. And when I pull it out of the slot, I don't pull it completely free of the block.
Yeah, do it slowly so I can see it.
As I pull it tight.
Oh, wow.
It captures the fibers between the two threads, and as you can see now, and I put it back against the surface, you end up with a tapered shape, real small at one end and large at the other end.
Perfect.
This is the end you'd tie in at the back end of the body on the hook, and this would be what you end up with at the thorax. And
then when you're done with that?
And I store them on cards that are cut with notches spaced down there. There's slots on each side for a dozen of these brushes. Put it in the slot on one side. Presto chango. There you go. And I always trim these ends off because they're messy. And I let those sit overnight before I use them. You can use them like this, but to do that, to keep it from coming undone, when I take it off the card, I grasp it in my hand like this. So I'm holding essentially both ends of it and it can't come untwisted. And
then you can start tying with it right from there?
I look at it like so to see how much I want to have thread showing at the back of end fly. Cut it off like so, and that's where I tie it in on the hook.
Okay.
From there, it's just a matter of wrapping it forward.
Okay.